violence and other kind of violence.
Get away! I'm going to be at work, at school, in my car, and I can still get shot by the police, but I can get shot anywhere!
So it is what it is.
What's good, YouTube? It's a Black Gen Z mindset. Make sure you go ahead and like, comment, share, subscribe. Let's get into the video.
Breaking from overnight, police say that a man was killed after he ordered from a taco truck. This happened around 9:30 last night on Irvington Boulevard and Caperton Street.
Dang. Shot the man down at a taco stand. It's crazy. It's out here. Okay. Nothing has changed. Especially in Texas, where a lot of this happens, okay? We had the Uvalde situation go down. People are, you know, upset about that, and rightfully so. But I think these types of situations are oftentimes overlooked as well. And the Uvalde situation needs all the attention that it can get right now, okay? And prayers out to the people who lost their children and their family members in that mass shooting. But you know, you would think that something like that would bring everybody together, but it seems like it's only getting worse.
Investigators say a man was waiting for his food for him and his wife when two unidentified men approached him and pulled out their guns, then fired. The man died at the scene. The victim's wife was also there, but she wasn't hurt. Police did not mention a motive, but they are looking into surveillance video.
North Houston, a husband and father is dead, and his family is demanding answers after an overnight shooting. Police say the man and his wife were out buying food on Irvington near East Cross Timbers, and that is when the attackers ran up and shot him. KPRC2's Brandon Walker joins us now from North Houston, where he's been talking to the devastated family members. Brandon.
And Keith, this happened just before 10:30 last night. So family want to know, with one, two, three businesses open here at that time last night, how is it, they ask, that no one saw anything?
It's my son.
Mark Aguilar Sr. didn't have the words to describe what doesn't make any sense. Who killed his son and why? Mark Aguilar Jr. was 24 years old.
Dang, man. And it looked like this brother had a promising life ahead of him, had his wife, you know, family, kids. And to think that you can just be ordering some tacos and they come gun you down. It looks like this is a Hispanic community, and you know, in the Uvalde situation we had a burrito gremlin. So this might be the same situation, not as in like the casualties, but it's getting wild out here, y'all. These burrito gremlins are on demon time.
You deserve that right there, laying there dead, man. Shot five times, man. Not my boy.
Sunday night in the parking lot next to the Walgreens at Irvington and East Cross Timbers is where Aguilar's life was taken. Houston police say Aguilar was buying tacos for himself and his wife.
As he was waiting for the tacos to be prepared, he went back to his vehicle where he was approached by two unidentified males at this time and shot him multiple times in the torso, and they fled the scene.
Dang. Just like that. Seems like it's a hit or something, or I don't know. But they playing dirty out here in these streets, y'all.
Monday, Mark's father, other family, friends, wore their grief as they placed flowers at the scene of the crime.
We worked together. He's a hardworking man. Everything he has, he worked for it.
He especially worked hard for his two-year-old daughter. She'll have to grow up without a father, just as her grandfather has to live without a son.
Not my boy, dog.
Man, and you could tell, like, the pain in his father's eyes, bro. Just, you know, we don't really see tears like that, okay, from the comunita. But the comunitino They ain't playing about this one.
And HPD spent the day combing the area looking for surveillance video. At last check, no word on what they were able to get. There is no description, at least released to us, of those two men. And so with that, police are asking anyone who may know anything to give the Homicide Division a call or Crime Stoppers. That number, 713-222-TIPS. Reporting live for you tonight on the North Side, I'm Brandon Walker, KPRC 2 News.
I'm here on the corner of MLK and Frederick Douglass, where a shooting just took place. And as you can see, it's a pretty rough area. So I'm basically risking my life reporting on this madness. So make sure you do me a favor and hit the subscribe button. Like the video, hell, share the video. And make sure you go ahead and leave a comment down in the comment section to continue the discussion on how we can find solutions to all this sun violence in the streets. I'm Jinquavius Jackson, here live, reporting from Atlanta, Georgia, BGZM News 17.
The search is on for two suspects who shot and killed a man while he was buying tacos from a food truck. This happened last night on Irvington Boulevard near Cross Timbers in North Houston, and that's where we find Zach Tawatari. Zach, this man was just trying to order some food.
Ron and Sherman, family, friends, hugging, crying, lots of tears today at this devastating scene behind me. The family tells me it was Mark Aguilar Jr. He was the man who was shot and killed here last night. They say he was just 23 years old, a good man, a straight-laced man. They can't believe this happened to him, and now they're searching for answers. Only about 50 feet from this popular neighborhood taco truck, a growing memorial for 23-year-old Mark Aguilar Jr., whose family says was the man gunned down near this spot Sunday night.
He didn't deserve this, not like that, by himself to come get him and his family tacos.
His father, Mark Aguilar Sr., devastated.
I never thought I'd say that. I know how it feels to lose a kid for the other parents, but today I do.
Mm. Aguilar's family says he used to come to this taco truck after work.
And, you know, they look like they probably make some slamming tacos, okay? It looks super greasy, super smacking. It looked like they don't raise the prices. But, you know, that's how it is, man. Inflation is killing everybody. And if the taco stand got to raise the prices, so be it. We need that food coming. It's crazy because you're messing up the business, having people scared to go to the taco stand. It's crazy, y'all. And it ain't letting up.
To get food for his wife and 2-year-old daughter. And police say it was just before 10:30 that he was walking back to his car when two unidentified males approached him and shot him multiple times before fleeing the scene. The taco truck manager didn't want us to show his face or use his name and says he didn't see what happened, but tells us they're all afraid in the truck, saying we are all scared because we are talking about guns. We are talking about guns, which is why we are scared.
Mm. And these folks just came over here to, you know, experience a better life. And you got these dudes in the streets, these hitters. For what reason they killed this man, I don't know, man. It seems like he was buttoned up, worked hard, didn't have mob ties or mafia ties, MM ties. I don't know, man. But it's just sad that, you know, one day you can be getting tacos with your family and the next they come and get you up out of here, man. We all knew it was going to be a bloody Memorial Day weekend. But this one hits hard, guys. These burrito gremlins are on demon time.
A longtime neighborhood resident who also didn't want us to identify her tells us this food truck is a place where people typically come to relax and hang out.
It's just a beautiful place, actually, to spend a Sunday evening. Yeah, so a lot of people come and congregate, and so we weren't really expecting anything like this.
Mark Sr. says he can't imagine why anyone would want to do this to his son.
Not my son. He don't fight. You don't argue. I taught him better than that.
But now Aguilar's family is left without their son, brother, husband, and father.
You can't raise her in case she'll get married, graduate.
So far, the police say they don't have a motive and those suspects didn't take anything. If you have any information, you're urged to call Houston police. In North Houston, Zach Tawatari, KHOU 11 News.
And that family is devastated. Thank you so much, Zach.
Gang violence and other kind of violence.
So it is what it is.